हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द आईटीलेस एकेडमी। इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद द लेक्चर ऑफ एडल्ट्रेंस, टेस्टिंग ऑफ एडल्ट्रेंस, द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज योर शुगर एडल्ट्रेंस टेस्टिंग। इन दिस वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट फर्स्ट द डिटेक्शन ऑफ द इनवर्ट शुगर इन द वाइट शुगर एंड द अपैरेटस रिक्वायर्ड हेयर इज योर टेस्ट ट्यूब, वाइट पोर्सिलेन इवेपोरेटिंग डिशेज यूज फॉर टाइट्रेशन टू एंश्योर बेटर डिटेक्शन ऑफ द एंड पॉइंट। Next is your the water bath maintained at boiling point and the reagents as alkaline copper solution, that is to dissolve 25 gram of anhydrous sodium carbonate and 25 gram of sodium potassium titrate tetrahydrate in 600 ml of distilled water containing 40 ml of normal sodium hydroxide solution in 1 liter volumetric flask. Dissolve 6 gram of cupric sulfate pentahydrate in about 100 ml of distilled water and quantitatively transfer to the alkaline tartrate solution and dilute to the mark and mix it. This is how you can make the alkaline copper solution. The principle behind this is the method is this is the method suitable for the determination of low invert sugar content, for example in white sugar, and it can be detectable up to 0.02%. A copper complex solution containing sodium carbonate as the main alkaline agent is used in this. When heated in the boiling water bath, the invert sugar reduces the cupric ion to cuprous oxide, and after cooling, the residual cupric ions are titrated with the EDTA using muriate as the indicator. And the experimental conditions include your weight of the sugar, the volume of the water, volume of alkaline copper solution, and time of heating are strictly standardized, and the result is obtained from the calibration curve. Here in this next reagent is your the EDTA solution of which you have to make 0.005 of normal. For this, you have to dissolve 0.9360 gram of EDTA dehydrated in distilled water and diluted to 1 liter in volumetric flask. Next is your the muriate indicator. Since muriate solution is not very stable, the indicator is best prepared in a solid state. You have to grind 0.5 gram muriate and 0.15 gram methylene blue and 40 gram of sodium chloride together using a pestle and mortar. To avoid cracking, store in a desiccator over silica gel. Use approximately 0.1 gram of solid indicator for each titration. So let's start with the procedure. You have to take 5 gram of sugar in 5 ml of cold distilled water in a test tube and add exactly 2 ml of alkaline copper solution which we have made in the reagents. After thorough mixing, place the tube in a boiling water bath for exactly 5 minutes and then cool immediately in a cold water bath. Transfer the solution and washings to a white evaporating dish and add approximately 0.1 gram of the indicator. Now titrate the mixture with 0.005 normal EDTA solution. The color changes from green through gray to purple, which is the end point. The gray stage appears just before the end point. When the purple color is reached, it disappears slowly owing to the oxidation of cuprous oxide at a rate which depends to some extent on the amount of cuprous oxide present. The end point should therefore be approached as rapidly as possible. So prepare a calibration curve giving ml of 0.05 normal EDTA solution against percent invert sugar ordinate. The curve should be linear up to 0.02 gram invert sugar per 100 gram of sucrose. Now read the amount of invert sugar directly from the calibration curve where the points are matched. Next test, it's not the test, it is the sample preparation of the sugar solution. Means before performing, sorry, I am giving this experiment have to be the first one, but anyways, you can learn it from here. Before performing any experiment, we have to prepare our sample, and the sugar is, we cannot use the directly sugar. We have to make a solution of the sugar, and this we have to prepare a sample for any particular test. The sample filled, the principle says the sample of filtered sample is mixed with ethanol so that the final concentration of the latter is 80% weight by volume by volume. Chalk is added to neutralize the acidity. The mixture is boiled on the water bath, diluted to volume, filtered and filtrate evaporated to remove alcohol. Any enzymes present are inactivated by the alcohol. Here the reagents required is your alcohol 95% and calcium carbonate precipitated. Let's see the procedure. You have to add the ground of finely chopped and baked sample to hot alcohol to which enough precipitated chalk has been added to neutralize the acidity. Using enough alcohol so that the final concentration allowing for water in the sample is 80% volume by volume. Heat nearly to boiling on a water bath for 1 hour, stirring frequently. The solution may be kept at this stage if it is not convenient to proceed immediately with the analysis. Decant the solution into a volumetric flask and mix the solids in a high speed blender with 80% alcohol. Boil the blended material on a water bath for 30 minutes, cool it and transfer to the volumetric flask and dilute to the volume with 80% volume by volume ethanol at 20 degrees Celsius. Now filter and evaporate an aliquot of the filtrate. Add water as necessary to prevent the solution evaporating to dryness. When the odor of alcohol disappears, add about 100 ml of water and heat to 80 degrees Celsius to soften gummy precipitates and break up insoluble masses. Filter through a thin mat of silite on a filter paper in a puncher funnel. Previously washed with the water until the washings are clear. After passing the sample solution through the silite, wash the latter with the water and dilute the combined filtrate and washings to a suitable volume, or use the entire filtrate, which should not be much in excess of 50 ml. Now this solution is now ready for clarification by lead acetate or for hydrolysis and final determination if clarification is not necessary. If it is necessary to determine starch in the product, boil the sample with the 80% of alcohol initially only for 30 minutes. Filter through a paper or extraction thimble, collecting the filtrate in a volumetric flask. Return any insoluble material to the beaker, boil an hour with 80% alcohol and filter through the same paper or thimble. If the extract is highly colored, repeat a third time. Finally, transfer the residue to the paper or thimble. Leave to drain and then dry. Grind the residue to pass a 1 mmc place thimble in a sauchlet extractor and extract 12 hours with 80% alcohol. The combined alcohol extracts are evaporated as above and the residue may be used for determination of starch. Next test is your the detection of chalk powder in sugar. You have to take a transparent glass filled with water. dissolve approximately 10 gram of sugar sample into the water. If sugar is mixed with the chalk, the adulterants will settle down at the bottom. Next is your detection of urea in the sugar. Take a sample of sugar in a test tube. Add some water in it to dissolve properly. Smell the solution. If there is no smell of ammonia, then it is an unadulterated sugar. If there is a smell of ammonia, then it is considered to be adulterated sugar. Thank you for being with us. For more information, please log on to our website www.itlsacademy.com, and you can also follow us on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp, LinkedIn, and yes, subscribe our channel at YouTube, ITLS Academy.